We're going to take word problems that you can set up using a single variable and solve by factoring. So for example, here's a word problem. The square of a negative number is 15 more than twice the negative number. Find the number. All right, so the trick is to read the problem carefully and then decide what you're looking for. You're looking for a number. So let's set up an equation, but first we want to define what we're looking for. So let's let n be the negative number we're looking for. Now there may be more than one solution to this. So when you say there's a negative number, it could be that there are two possible negative numbers, or maybe there's only one. So it says the square of a negative number is 15 more than twice the negative number. The square of a negative number. Well, if this is the negative number, n squared would be the square of it. All right, so we're taking and breaking this up. The square of a negative number, that's sort of the left side of the equation, because we have is, meaning usually equals, right? 15 more than twice the negative number. Okay, 15 more than something. All right, so that means you have to add 15 to something, right? You're going to add 15, because it says 15 more than something, more than twice the negative number. All right, well, if n's the negative number, twice the negative number would then be 2n. So this is an equation to represent this sentence, if we're going to let the variable be n. And I used n for a negative number. Okay, now this has an n squared, so this is not a linear equation. So to do the nonlinear equations, we're going to set the equation equal to 0. So I'll have n squared minus 2n minus 15 equals 0. And now use any method you'd like to factor n squared minus 2n minus 15, the left-hand side of the equation. You could do that on scratch paper. What's important is you get the correct factors and then you put it in here. So that's going to be n minus 5 and n plus 3. It's the winning combination here. Then what do? We set each factor equal to 0. So n minus 5 equals 0, or n plus 3 equals 0. Okay, so let's see. That would mean n is 5, or n is negative 3. Now here's where word problems are very different than just solving equations. We have to go back and make sure that these solutions make sense when we read the original problem. It says, the square of a negative number is 15 more than twice the negative number. Find the number. Okay, first of all, we're looking for a negative number. So 5 can't be what we're looking for, because that's not even negative. So then we're saying, I wonder if the number is negative 3. So let's just see if this makes sense. The square of that number. Okay, if the number is negative 3, what would the square of the number be? It would be 9, right? The question is, that more, is that 15 more than twice the negative number? Well, twice the negative number, well, if the number is negative 3, twice it would be negative 6, right? And 15 more than that would be 9, right? So I'm sort of like reading the problem. It's saying, is the square of the negative number, which is over here, that's the square of the negative number, the square of negative 3, basically. And this is 15 more than twice the negative number. So that's twice the negative number. Twice negative 3, right? And I added 15. Yes, I got 9. Certainly is 15 more than twice negative 3. So negative 3 must be the correct solution. Notice I didn't go back and plug it back into the equation, because I might have written the wrong equation. I want to make sure it makes sense in my words. So then we have to write this answer. The number is negative 3. Remember, you wouldn't write n equals negative 3. Look at the problem. They don't talk about an n. It says find the number. You got to tell them what the number is. It's an English problem, and you answer in English.